renovating your home is such a unique experience because obviously it needs to be functional, but you also want to create a space that feels like a reflection of who you are.
Darren, what do you want the house to feel like? Like, what is it? Like, what do you want to walk through the door?
To feel like home for the kids as well, you know what I mean? And, you know, they're getting older. My oldest daughter just turned 15 yesterday, you know
what
I mean?
How old is your other daughter?
She's going to be 13. I really wanted to give them a, you know, a nice place to hang out and a nice home.
I really adore Darren and Lisa. They've worked so hard to find a home, buy the home, create this space for their children to grow up in, and all he keeps saying is he wants to create a space beautiful enough for his daughters.
I want to be the hangout house where our kids' friends hang out.
Yeah. I want to be the hangout house for the rest of my children's lives. Bottom line is, you guys are not house proud yet.
No.
We want to do, we want to make it a house, a home, but we just don't know where to start. You know what I mean?
And we didn't always agree.
Yes, and that too, yes. We're not designers, so...
Well, one of us is extremely talented.
Thank you. That's so
kind.
You,
of course.
Wow, it's just amazing.
Hold on. Mike just sent me a text message with a video. It's never good.
I mean, old houses inevitably have things that come up, especially when you're starting to renovate them.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
So here's our problem back here.
Oh, no.
When they renovated the upstairs, they cut these joists. So now there's nothing supporting the second floor.
Why? How?
The whole house is sinking.
Any support that they did have before is now gone because of our whole open concept.
So our plan was to open up the entire first floor, but it turns out when the second floor of the home was renovated years ago, they cut some of the joists, which means that the entire second floor of the home is being supported on the walls of the first floor.
So that entire change to make everything structurally sound now, we find out from Mike, it's gonna be $37,000. I think we have to call.
Yeah.
In that, I think you should do this.
Call.
Here we go.
Hi.
Hi, Jeremiah. How are you?
Hey, guys, how are you?
We're doing well. How are you guys hanging in there?
We're hanging in there.
Yeah.
So, guys, we are really excited about everything happening at your home, but I'm calling with a little bit of uncomfortable news. So when your upstairs bathroom was renovated, it looks like they had to cut some of the joists.
Wow.
They never supported the second story of your home correctly.
And when,
yes.
Okay. It's definitely a bit of a scary issue, but I really do believe that the positive side of this is that we caught it. The negative side of it is that it is going to be expensive to remedy.
It's a $37,000 problem. We had $17,000 earmarked for a contingency in case anything went wrong. So really what we're coming to you and asking you for is $20,000.
$20,000?
Yes.
Okay. You know, it's still a lot of money, but, you know, it has to be done. We'll figure it out.
It's an expensive surprise, but it's worth the investment. This family is going to finally have a home that's safe and structurally sound, and that's what matters.
What's going on, man?
How are you, boss?
How are you doing? Long time no see.
Good to see you. I know.
I cannot believe how big the bathroom is going to be.
Yes.
And it's a nice size shower.
32 inches.
It is. It's a really nice size shower. All right.
And we put the controls on this wall and the head's over there.
So they reach in here.
The vanity's gonna be in your way.
You're right.
Well, I like this anyway, because then you have to get under the water to make it warm.
Right.
Okay.
What about our vintage mirror we found at the flea market?
Let's see if it works.
When we spoke with you on the phone and you sent that video, this is the solution. It almost looks like you built a steel cage around the whole house.
Transferred the load to the foundation.
They're gonna freak out though. I mean, the fact that this house is all open like this, it feels like an entirely different house. Listen, the surprise of what we needed to do with this house structurally was a hard one to swallow. But at the end of the day, the house is structurally sound. It costs a lot more money, but it's safe, and it was important for this family.
You know, we were talking a little bit about the swing of this door since the cabinetry will be here. I think we just put a stopper in the floor.
Okay.
I don't think there's another solution to that. The other suggestion was swinging it
the other way.
Yeah, but I think it's weird to come in one way and open up a neck. I think they both have to be in line.
Is this a metal door?
No. This is what this door is, and I think we're replacing it. This door at one time was a French door, 15 light, and someone put a panel in front of it and shoe molding from a floor.
Oh my God, I wish it was 15
light. Is there glass
light.
Still there's, in there?
I bet you there's glass still in there.
What if we can put the glass, take it off?
Oh, we would love that.
I would kill for the 15 light glass door.
Yeah. I guarantee you that's what that was.
Oh my
and
God.
They covered it up.
You've got to be kidding treasure. Me.
No, there's some. This is shoe molding from a floor.
Well, can we pick it off? Do you have anything on you?
No, oh, right I can't now. Take it off now.
No?
The next time you guys come by, I'll show it to you.
It's like a
It's procedure. A French, it's an old French door with the original hardware and the original hinge.
I just love the fact that we found this treasure potentially in a house of people who love treasures.
Holy.
Wow.
This is not our house.
Oh my God. This is unbelievable.
It's beautiful, guys.
It's hard to believe this is our house.
I absolutely love it. This is
really? Amazing.
I could not even imagine something like this.
Wow.
Like, I don't even know where to look first.
Your nice, beautiful little window seat moment now that you have, but that you wasn't there
and
before.
And I am going to have a glass of wine there.
Exactly.
And the kids can grab their books. Yep. And
that's actually antique, the chair we found. We went antiquing for you guys.
Oh my God.
Like, we had it recovered to match some of the blue, like denim pillows.
Wow.
And jeans.
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 You wanted to feel like a pair of jeans.
You wanted to feel like your favorite pair of jeans.
Do you notice what we found under your door?
Yeah,
this was there. This was your door. But we were like, why does it feel like there's something in? And we took off, it was panels that were hiding this antique.
Why do people do that?
I don't know.
Really?
Yes, original hardware, it was there. It was just hiding, the old diamond in the rough.
And then, of course, you guys, your console.
It looks amazing.
Doesn't it look good there?
Yes.
That's where it all started.
Yep. Look at this happy couple. We love this photo.
What about your staircase now?
I know, when you come in, everything just was like, opens up. My gosh. It really does look a completely different house.
Yeah.
And look at our fireplace.
I know, right?
I love the rustic mantle there.
Those are lamps that we found from your vintage shopping. So at night, there's like pretty ambient lighting.
Speaking of lighting, look at this.
Wow. Who would have known? You know, I was always curious what colors they
were. I had hoped for a white golden glow.
Yes.
And look at the lantern.
There's your lantern.
This is just incredible.
Amazing.
So check out the dining room, guys. Look
at this.
Remember,
there was a wall.
Yes.
Gone. Now you've got the new sliding
doors.
Wow.
Oh my God. Look at your bottle collection. That's actually an amazing way of putting them.
Yep. How pretty do those look?
Yes. Yeah.
I think what we connect to most with Darren and Lisa is the intention behind what they keep and collect. You know, everything has a story, whether it's from their past or things that they've collected or reminds Darren of being a child in Australia. That matters to us. And our hope is that with this space now, they look around and not only do they see their past and their present, but there's room for their future.
Well said, babe.
Thanks.
Oh my God.
Oh my, wow. This is unbelievable, guys.
So this is remarkable.
Can you believe the size of what is in here?
This, yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to think now how it was before.
You were just in the corner.
And then probably most exciting, guys, because this was one bathroom.
You know, four people sharing one bathroom.
Exactly. Check that out.
Oh my God. This is gorgeous.
Wow. That's a big room.
Ugh.
Shower's awesome. Look
this
at
is
love
beautiful.
The color.
I love it.
Wow, that's crazy. Thinking
that, we
that
could
the
fit
kit, that the everything that was here before.
You guys like totally nailed this. Like,
outdid yourselves
me.
On this one.
13 years of waiting for a house to be a home and to just love what it was that we were walking into.
And to walk into something like this is just amazing.
You gave us $185,000. We had that big snafu with the foundational work and the steel work that needed to happen so that the second story didn't fall on us. That was another 20. You're in for 205.
Money well spent.
And the place looks phenomenal.
Are you proud of it now?
I am. I can't wait to have everybody over.
Yes.